Day, ladies and gentlemen, young and old, friends of the Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation, and most importantly, friends of Jacques Gauthier, our honoree today. I am Andrea Spindle, the Executive Director of CAEF, and I'm thrilled to introduce our virtual celebration of the centennial of the San Remo Declaration and honoring Jacques Gauthier, a very special friend of the Jewish people. We have a beautiful program lined up for you today, but first a short word about CAEF. The Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation has been operating in the Ontario region for almost 20 years, urging the Jewish community and our allies to pay attention to increasing anti-Semitism and its many and varied iterations, most recently that being anti-Zionism. We generate educational content, conduct awareness and advocacy initiatives, and promote a proud, unapologetic Zionism. April 26, 2020 was the 100th anniversary of the conference of the Supreme Allied Council in San Remo, Italy, following World War I, and at it was signed the San Remo Resolution that committed the United Kingdom to facilitating the reconstitution of the Jewish homeland in Palestine, thus creating the mandate for Palestine and recognizing the Jewish people as a nation, affirming their right to self-determination in their ancient biblical home. Our celebration of San Remo was postponed because of COVID-19, but we were undeterred and we are happy to be celebrating now before the year is over. Let 2020 not be remembered only for the overwhelming concern we have for the country and the world. Let it also be remembered for bringing people together, for connecting us via Zoom with people and places we might not otherwise have reached, and for giving us this amazing technology to connect now, allowing us to celebrate a local hero while remembering our history and learning more about what connects Jacques Gauthier to Israel and the Jewish people worldwide. It is my pleasure to introduce your host for this program, Louis Mitz. Louis is a real estate lawyer and entrepreneur in Toronto. He is a founder of the Song Shul, president of the Jerusalem Foundation, and a contributor to many charitable causes. He is married to Wendy Postlins, with whom he has 6 married children, 9 grandchildren, and 2 more on the way. Louis is also, of course, a friend of Jacques Gauthier. Over to you, Louis.
Thank you, Andrea. And thank you to the Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation for creating the virtual celebration and inviting us, all of us, to join with you today. I want to begin by thanking the following community support organizations, which were eager to have their names added to an event that recognized Dr. Jacques Gauthier, whose legacy is something to celebrate as we remember and commemorate the San Remo Conference. In no particular order, thank you to the European Coalition for Israel, the Institute for Global Studies in Antisemitism and Policy, the International Legal Forum, the International Christian Embassy of Jerusalem, Canada, the Law Fair Project, Honest Reporting Canada, the Song Shul, Beth Avraham Yosef Toronto, the BATE, Beth Tikva Synagogue, Beth Tzedek Synagogue, the Toronto Zionist Council, Doctors Against Racism and Anti-Semitism, the Canadian Jewish Civil Rights Association, the Canadian Institute of Jewish Research, Americans for a Safe Israel, Hadassah Wiesel Canada, Friends of Jesus Christ Canada, Hasbara Fellowships, Israel Truth Week, ART Canada, the Jerusalem Foundation of Canada, the Center for Israel and Jewish Affairs, B'nai B'rith Canada, and Canadian Friends of Jerusalem College of Technology, and our lead support organization, Canadians for Israel Legal Rights. That was hard to do, I can tell you. Remember all those names. We are aware of many other organizations which either did reach out to offer support or would have gladly been, but for the time did not permit us to expand the list. Please accept our appreciation to those who we did miss. I would be remiss if I didn't acknowledge the tremendous work done by CAEF and the task force that organized our virtual celebration, chaired by Shirley Ann Haber, founder of the Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce our opening special guest, Consul General of Israel, Ms. Galit Baram, who will share greetings from the Israel Consulate and welcome all of you today. Galit, over to you.
Shalom. Hello. In these days of global pandemic, we all have learned to adapt to a new work environment and see each other on social media. face-to-face meetings are the bread and butter of diplomacy, and personally, I miss them very much. Hopefully soon, once a vaccine is approved and distributed, there will be a better chance for all of us to resume a certain sense of normalcy. Until then, online meetings we'll have to do. Several months ago, the Embassy of Israel in Rome was planning a big event in commemoration of 100 years to the San Remo Conference. Israel's ambassador in Italy, Dror Eidal, was planning to discuss the dramatic achievement of the San Remo Conference, that conference that too many people are conveniently trying to forget, the conference in which the legal foundations of Israel's international legitimacy were laid. Unfortunately, the event had to be postponed due to COVID, but we are obliged to bring that historic conference back to international awareness. Those who follow the truth must be familiar with this conference and its great importance and relevance today. It was the first president of Israel, Chaim Weizmann, who said that the San Remo Conference was the biggest political event in the history of the Zionist movement, maybe even in the history of the Jewish people since the exile. It was a defining moment in the history of the Jewish people, he said, no less. Dr. Jacques Gauthier has dedicated his life to researching and writing about the San Remo Conference. His dedication to the research of historic truth is admirable. On countless occasions, he has discussed his study and has attended conferences and academic events around the globe. He addressed fellow scholars, lawyers, diplomats, politicians, always with great enthusiasm and conviction, demonstrating his impressive expertise. Israel is a unique example of an ancient people that has returned to its ancestral land, a strong and resilient democracy. It is challenged in the international arena, its legitimacy questioned on social media, its reputation smeared. While Israel is repeatedly singled out, regimes that are serial violators of human rights, which constitute a threat to democracy, to peace and stability, such regimes are left untouched. In such days, I believe that Dr. Gauthier's study should reach much bigger audiences, scholars, researchers, academics, politicians, diplomats, and journalists could all benefit from his brilliant work. Hopefully, after the pandemic is long forgotten, it will be possible to celebrate 100 years to the San Remo Conference in the city of San Remo, as was originally planned. On behalf of the State of Israel, congratulations to Dr. Gauthier, tonight's honoree, who will receive the Advocate Award of Excellence. I also wish to thank the Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation for organizing this event. Thank you, and stay healthy.
Thank you for your thoughtful message. Galit, it's most appreciated. Before we proceed further with the program, I'd like to add a few moments of personal message to Jacques. I wish to tell you how honored I am to be able to participate in today's milestone event. Jacques and I go back a long time as friends, partners, confidants, and respected members of the bar. We share many wonderful memories, have spent time in each other's homes in Israel and Italy. We have gone to synagogue and church together. Our friendship, respect for one another has no boundaries. Now back to the program. Most of you will be familiar with the famous Balfour Declaration, a letter signed November 2nd, 1917 by British Foreign Secretary Sir Arthur Balfour to Lord Walter Rothschild, a leader of the British Jewish community, for transmission to the Zionist Federation of Great Britain and Ireland. Balfour promised to support, and I quote, the establishment in Palestine of a national home for the Jewish people, respect the civil and religious rights of existing non-Jewish communities in Palestine, and the rights and political status enjoyed by Jews in any other country. Many events followed this auspicious declaration, and no one knows these better than today's honoree, Dr. Jacques Gauthier. But after today, we hope all of our viewers will know and share this important piece of history. Post-World War I, the Supreme Council of the Allied Powers, which included the United Kingdom, Britain, France, and Italy, allocated a sizable area of the mandate for Palestine to the Jewish people. The April 26, 2020 date should also be emblazoned in your memory and that of all your children, as the Jewish people continue to seek justice and sovereignty in the land of Israel as it designated at the San Remo and confirmed by the League of Nations in 1922. To fill us in on more details and to bring to the fore the much heralded work of Dr. Gauthier, we have several speakers who will bring full expression of our appreciation to Jacques today. You will hear from several people who have known Jacques through decades and from several who have just come to know him recently and his work. I will introduce four wonderful people who will each speak for a few minutes about what they deem as very important and impressive in Jacques' career and how they know him personally. I then will have the pleasure of introducing the first of several musical performances prepared especially for today and to add a special memory of today's event. Our first speaker is going to be Michael Diamond, a dear friend for a long time. Over to you, Michael.
Thanks, Louis. Over a decade ago, you, Louis, did me a great favor. You introduced me to Jacques Gauthier. Louis talked enthusiastically about Jacques, his study of the legal rights of the Jewish people to Jerusalem. And Louis handed me a very large and very heavy manuscript, which was Jacques' PhD thesis on that subject. And while I will not tell you that I read the entire thesis, I did read enough to know that I needed to meet this unusual man. That introduction has led to not only a good deal of learning on my part, but a valuable friendship with a very special person. Later in this program, others with more expertise than I will elaborate on the importance of San Remo to the Jewish people, but let me provide a quick overview. We're all aware of the Balfour Declaration of 1917, which has been referenced a few times already in this program. Balfour was an important turning point, but it was limited in its initial impact because it was a letter of intent from one country. It took San Remo to bring the Balfour Declaration to life. What Jacques has taught us is the importance of the 7-day-long San Remo Conference, which published its binding resolution signed by multiple countries on April 25, 1920. San Remo laid the political foundation for the creation of not just the only Jewish state of Israel, but the 22 Arab League states. In fact, the full text of the Balfour Declaration became an integral part of the San Remo resolution, as well as of the British mandate for Palestine. That thereby transformed Balfour from a letter of intent into a legally binding foundational document under international law. This is the core of Jacques' considerable expertise, which encompasses the impact of San Remo and what came before and after. This is what Jacques has been sharing privately and publicly ever since his thesis was completed and accepted. And this is why Jacques is so special. He is not an employee of a nonprofit, which is focused on this initiative. He is not Jewish, although he is certainly a Zionist. What Jacques is, we have learned, is a wonderful man, a man with a mission to teach the Jewish people, as well as both our allies and our detractors, the truth about the legal rights of the Jewish people to Jerusalem, and by extension, the lands of Judea and Samaria. Jacques is actually not a political activist. He does not prescribe an appropriate outcome for the conflict, but rather he simply focuses on the legal facts of the matter, and suggests that in any negotiations towards a final resolution of the conflict, that these legal rights should be one of the pillars of such negotiations. Jacques has invested a big part of his life over the past decade and more in sharing these truths with people around the world, from Israel to Paris, from the Vatican to the UK, Canada and the US. His presentations are always clear, legally consistent, and so incredibly valuable. Years ago when we met, Jacques was working very hard to get noticed. Today we know that he has succeeded because his name and his teachings are known around the world. He has brought San Remo to life and strengthened Israel in the process. In particular, he has taught the Israelis who do the direct negotiating that they have a very strong legal position in international law, something that had gotten lost in the quagmire of difficult negotiations for far too long. So why does a Christian lawyer in Toronto take up such a challenge? That is for Jacques to tell us himself. But the fact that he has dedicated a good deal of his life to this cause says a good deal. This is a man of goodness, of truth, and a man with a mission. He is persuasive and stubborn, and he conducts himself with grace, with intelligence, and with utmost humility. In doing so, he has been supported by his incredible family, his wonderful wife and four amazing daughters, all of whom have the same virtues as he does, commitment to honesty, the truth, and to sharing that truth. Thank you to CAEF and all the organizations which have supported this event. Thank you for giving me the honor to speak about Jacques and his efforts. Jacques has tried very hard to educate the Jewish people in the world at large about the rights of the Jewish people to the lands, and I'm happy to say that he has succeeded. So I say to Jacques in closing, thank you for your friendship, thank you for who you are, and Kol HaKavod for all that you do. Thank you.
Michael, it's something that I would be remiss to tell the people on the program today who you are and that we've been friends since the 50s. And just to fill in the little missing information about you, you're an entrepreneur and a philanthropist with deep ties to Israel and the Jewish people in Canada. As a Jew and as a Zionist, you've been advocating on Israel's right to exist freely without attacks as the world's only Jewish state. Michael, we know you were introduced to Jacques almost a decade ago, and I know he was overwhelmed with your appreciation and support, as I was. With respect to our visits to San Remo, it's been a joy and a memory for us to have shared with you the trip 3 years ago, which was the actual 100th year of Balfour's declaring his declaration. And from that event, we have amazing memories and met wonderful people from all over the world. Michael, you know, you're an active member and a philanthropist in this our community and all of over Canada. And I'm very proud of you for bringing the Shin Shanim program to Canada. Today is in you're investing the majority of your philanthropic time in the UJA Federation of Greater Toronto, as well as Hillel and the Institute for the Study of Global Antisemitism and Policy. Aside from these involvements, you will find that you are involved in many other endeavors as a mentor, connector, philanthropist, investor, cheerleader, and teacher. And I'm very proud to have called you my friend for so many years. Now, I guess we'd like to introduce our next speaker, who is Dr. Charles Small. Charles is the founder and executive director of the Institute for Global Studies in Antisemitism and Policy, and a research scholar at St. Anthony's College, Oxford University. Charles is originally a Montrealer whose academic career has included groundbreaking work in the emerging field of contemporary antisemitism studies, the academic training for professors, authorizing many books and articles, including the 6 volumes, Global Antisemitism, A Crisis of Modernity and Teaching at Columbia University, Fordham University, Harvard, McGill, the National University of Kiev, Rome, and the Sorbonne, and more. Charles is committed to creating scholarly programming and research on contemporary antisemitism and establishing it as a recognized academic discipline. Currently, he is also working on confronting the antisemitism that exists on university campuses, both in the US and Canada, identifying its source, supporting the adoption of the International Holocaust Remembrance Alliance definition of antisemitism by university administrators, and developing curricula that can be shared worldwide. Charles, thank you for joining us today. We're looking forward to hearing what you have to say.
Thank you very much. I'd like to thank, first of all, the CAF and Andrea for inviting me to such an important event. I'm honored to be with the other panelists, and I'm especially honored to be speaking on such a special occasion for Jacques Gauthier, who's really, I think, an intellectual and legal giant in the field, and his work has had many positive implications of shedding light onto the truth. And I think his work will certainly stand the test of time. So I'm really honored to be here with you, Jacques Gauthier, today. So Jacques' work is so important. I also met him and I received this his doctoral thesis on Jerusalem. It's incredibly detailed research. He takes the reader through the key aspects of defining and putting into fact, legal facts, the sovereignty that the Jewish people have over Jerusalem. He takes us through the Balfour Declaration of 1917, the Paris Conference of 1919, the League of Nations engagement, of course, San Remo, the partition plan, and how the Jewish people have a right to establish themselves within Jerusalem. And not only does he take us through these sort of legal important legal documents and conferences and law, but he also, as the Consul General said, he reminds the Jewish people, I think, in a sense of who we are historically. He goes back and provides maps from the first century that when I looked at them and Jacques explained them to me when we first met, actually blew my mind. I didn't understand the details of our history, of the Jewish people's history in Jerusalem, and how Jerusalem truly belongs to the Jewish people in a deep sense, a legal sense, a cultural inheritance, and our heritage levels as well. So we speak about the establishment of Israel, but it's actually the reestablishment of Israel. I think that Jacques' work really points to the fact that it's a reestablishment of the sovereignty of the indigenous people, if you will, of Israel and of Jerusalem. So I come from this, and my academic work is more on the study of contemporary anti-Semitism. As we know, as I'm sure everybody who's listening in today, there's different phases of anti-Semitism. There was a religious phase. There was a sort of a racist nationalist phase. And I think the most dominant form of the anti-Semitism, which is targeting the Jewish people, is the delegitimization of who we are as a people, the delegitimization of Israel as a sovereign entity, and our historical claim to Israel. And how I think what's very important is that Zionism and Israel is being bashed. And I remember not too long ago, there was a survey done by some pollsters in the United States. It was in 2010, and they were advising leading Jewish organizations not to use the word Zionism anymore, because Zionism became a bad word. It wasn't, you can't package it and sell it. And these experts were telling Jewish organizations to stop using the word Zionism. And we can see the erosion of our understanding of a people, of who we are and where we come from. And we see students and faculty on campuses moving away from Zionism, moving away from being proud of our heritage and our association and connection, our deep connection to not only Israel and Jerusalem, but who we are as a people. So, and in a sense, if we lose the sovereignty of Jerusalem, Jerusalem is the heart, not only of the Jewish people, but it's the heart of our claim to the land. If we give up our claim to Jerusalem, then what? Then what do we have left in terms of a legal claim, but also a claim of who we are as a people and our connection to Israel and to Jerusalem? So I think that the work of Jacques is of paramount importance, because he really lays the framework and the history of our claim and who we are, who the Jewish people are as a sovereign nation. And his work is really so important in the historical, legal context for sure, but also I think in the contemporary context with this onslaught of anti-Semitism from political Islam and the radical left. And the radical left, I think, has a place in the record of media and in our sort of liberal academic institutions. So a lot of Jacques' work is interestingly portrayed sometimes as right-wing in this political climate. But if you read the documentation, if you read this sort of expert analysis and the details of his work, you can see it's rooted in fact, it's rooted in history, and it's rooted in law. And this is an invaluable contribution to these attempts to not only delegitimize and demonize Israel, but delegitimize and demonize the Jewish people as a whole. So Jacques, it's really an honor to be here, and kol hakavod and continued strength and success for all that you've done and all that you will do. Thank you.
Thank you too, Charles. And thank you for the great work that you do and keeping us on the straight and narrow with the rest of the population. So our next speaker, with whom I'm very happy to introduce, is coming to us today from Tel Aviv. Attorney Yifa Sigel is currently the director of the International League Forum, ILF, a nonprofit legal hub dedicated to the global cooperation between lawyers, organizations such as CAEF, ISGAP, and others, and activists from all over the world, providing them with the knowledge and strategic planning, research, and international network needed in order to effectively fight against radical ideologies, terror, and the BDS movement. Previously, Yifa was the joint director of the Tzapit News Service, the only Israeli news agency disseminating news in real time from Israel to media outlets across the world. Prior to that role, Yifa was a leading member of the Israel Law Center, Shoret Hadin. She has a BA in law and an MA in international relations, and she will tell us how her work has been much influenced by the monumental work of Jacques. Over to you, Yifa.
Thank you so much, Lewis. And I'm really appreciative of this event. This is amazing and it's incredibly important. And I'm so honored to be asked to speak. And I hope you can hear me properly because there's an incredible storm outside and the internet is keep on getting disconnected. And, you know, they've sent the Jewish people back to the desert, but they didn't think of all these, you know, other possibilities that we will encounter these challenges. Anyway, as I said, I'm so honored to be giving this opportunity to speak at this event because we're not only celebrating the Sanremo event resolution, but also it's an opportunity for me to convey my respect and gratitude to my esteemed colleague and valued friend, Jacques Gauthier. And if I'm being more accurate, it's actually not only my gratitude that I wish to convey, but it is of all my fellow Zionist friends worldwide. And I want to tell you, when I first met Jacques, which was over a pint of beer at the Ben Yehuda market in Jerusalem, if you remember Jacques, I quickly learned that this man deserves my admiration, but not only for his professional contribution, but also for his unique personality. But that was more than clear to me because a man that chooses to dedicate such a significant part of his brilliant skills and promising career to such a crazy far-reaching goal must be unique. So when Jacques started working on his legal analysis, it required a real vision, as these legal issues surrounding the land of Israel weren't really central as they are today. Although by cleverly reading the map, I think Jacques was able to see something that most couldn't, and that this issue is key, and it must be thoroughly and professionally be researched, written, and published in order for the truth to be able to finally see the light of day. And so Jacques was really laying the groundwork for one of the most important battles of our generation. So Jacques' battle has now become central on world stage, as this issue is at the root of everything that we now have to deal with. It's the source of most of modern anti-Semitism, BDS, delegitimization of the state of Israel and the Jewish people worldwide. It's all based on what I call pseudo-legal arguments, right? And so we all know them. Israel is an illegal occupier. Israel is a colonist oppressor. The state of Israel has no right to exist. These are all pseudo-legal arguments. And so we all know that these seemingly righteous arguments pointing at the Jewish state and the Jewish people and all of our supporters worldwide. And I myself have chosen a career that seemed crazy to most, at least at the time, as very few foresaw that this false legal narrative would actually force us to fight a war for our very survival. And so for over a decade, I've been dealing with these arguments and their current counter arguments all of the days and nights. And it was Jacques' work that cleared path, right, for activists like me to start and build from, whether it's before domestic courts, parliaments, international organizations, or even the International Criminal Court. They all base their arguments on the same fundamentally wrong premise, that the land of Israel does not belong to the Jews, that our presence in this land is actually, so they claim, a distortion of justice. Well, I would like to take this opportunity to really thank you, Jacques. It is your work that initially proved that in addition to historic, moral, and theological arguments, it is actually international law that fully supports our claim to the land. This is a lesson that we first must learn ourselves. And like Jacques, that does not rest and just goes from country to country, from parliament to parliament, from hall to hall, and tells these facts to whoever is willing to listen. We have taken our cue from you. And there are more and more of us that are working to spread the message and truth about our historical and legal rights. I've always said that we can't expect to win a battle that we haven't fought. Most people don't have that luxury. But the Jews for certain do not. But when we fight, we win, and we have no other choice. It might be hard, it might take time, it might require creativity, determination, but our message of truth will prevail. And so we must all take our cue from Jacques, learn our history, and familiarize ourselves with the legal arguments, even those of us who aren't lawyers, because we must all understand that this is a central battlefield in the Jewish war of survival of our generation. So once again, Jacques, thank you so much.
Toda rabbah, Yifa, and shalom to all of our friends in Israel, of whom Jacques has many. Our fourth presenter is Rabbi Daniel Korobkin, whom I have the pleasure to introduce. Rabbi Korobkin is the spiritual leader of Beth Avraham Yosef Synagogue in Toronto, better known as the Beit. He received his rabbinic ordination from Ne'er Israel Rabbinical College in Baltimore, where he studied Jewish law, ethics, and philosophy. He received his MA in medieval Jewish and Islamic thought from UCLA, and an MSc in engineering from Johns Hopkins University, and he served as an adjunct professor at Muhlenberg College. Before moving to Canada in 2001, Rabbi Korobkin was Rosh Kalila at Yavna in Los Angeles and provided synagogue services for the Orthodox Union's entire West Coast region. He was founding rabbi of a synagogue in San Diego and is the author of the new translation of a classic philosophical work. Since 2019, he serves also as president of the Rabbinical Council of America. Before the pandemic, Jacques provided several presentations to the Beit members and friends, and we know this has had a profound impact on those in attendance and spawned a friendship between the rabbi and Jacques. So we look forward to hearing from Rabbi Korobkin as soon as possible, like right now.
Thank you, Louis. Thank you, Andrea Spindell and the CAEF, for this tremendous opportunity to say words of appreciation to Dr. Gauthier. Jacques and I met at a coffee house a little bit over a year ago, and I have to confess that I was curious why this non-Jew would be so concerned about the legal status of the state of Israel. I was immediately taken by this energetic man who has a twinkle in his eyes and a fire in his belly. He explained to me that he had originally approached this issue years ago from an academic perspective, dispassionately and objectively. And the truth is, he was working under a supervisor who had come to opposing conclusions. But this did not deter Dr. Gauthier, who worked relentlessly and undeterred to arrive at the legal facts. And since then, he has been working relentlessly to present his findings to the public. Today, now perhaps arguably more than ever before, especially now that there are so many changes to our neighbors down south in the United States, and perhaps we will be facing, we don't know yet, but there's a possibility that we'll be facing a new regime that will be less sympathetic to the Jewish state and its claims of sovereignty, Jacques' voice is more vital than ever. But what is still lacking? It's within our own community. Jacques is only one man and he needs our assistance. Anyone who is on this call and your families and your children and your relatives all need to be aware of this message and need to be active participants in the work that Jacques is doing. Because if we don't understand our own history, then how can we speak on Israel's behalf effectively? Our children need to know about San Remo, in addition to the Balfour Declaration and the 1947 partition plan and everything else that revolves around the founding of the modern state of Israel. Our community leaders need to know and be well-versed in these issues. And to that end, Jacques has generously given of his time and his energy and his knowledge to speak to so many Jewish organizations, but more importantly, to speak to young Jewish students in our yeshivot, in our schools. And by doing this, he is providing them with knowledge that they will be able to take with them to the university campus before they are subject to a tremendous amount of pressure and ideological retooling of their minds when they get to campus. He is also speaking to rabbis across North America. And I'm proud to have been able to make some of those introductions that will enable Dr. Gauthier to proliferate his message far and wide. So in conclusion, Jacques, may I give you the following blessing. May God bless you. May he grant you the strength and good health to continue your vital work on behalf of Israel and the Jewish people. We thank you.
Thank you, Rabbi. Those words are going to encourage all of us to Shep Nachas with and on Jacques. Moving on now to the second part of our program, we have a very special musical performance, and I'm very thrilled to welcome Cantor Simon Spiro, the spiritual leader of the Chazon at the Song Shul, and Aliza Spiro, his wife, the Song Shul's creative director. Also, we'd like to share a word with Jacques. They have selected a song that very much fits our theme of commemorating San Remo and honoring Jacques, whose pinnacle work supports the only legitimate claim of any people to Jerusalem, and that of the Jewish people. Welcome, Simon and Aliza.
Thank you, Lewis. Hi, good evening. We're so excited to be joining you tonight on this wonderful and so well-deserved occasion. Congratulations, Mazal Tov, to Jacques and Rani on this fantastic honor.
We are so happy that we can be here with you, and it is such a well-deserved honor. Jacques, you were one of the very first speakers that we ever had at the Song Shul. We will never forget it. We are so grateful to you for that. And all I can say is that the depth of your understanding about Jerusalem is only matched by your brilliant ability to share your understanding and to share your knowledge with those who are fortunate enough to be around you. You are a true friend to Israel. You are a true friend to the Jewish people. You are a cherished friend of the Song Shul and Simon and me. We're thrilled that you are being honored this evening, and we wish you Mazal Tov with all our hearts. We have a very special song that Simon is going to sing for you.
Yeah, we've chosen a song in English about Jerusalem, and you are the spokesperson for the world when it comes to Jerusalem. The song is called Jerusalem is Mine.
And it's dedicated to you, Jacques.
Thank you. I am your guiding light. You are a book whose leaves are torn. I am the page you write. You are the branches of a tree. I am a clinging vine. I am your prayer, Jerusalem. Jerusalem is mine.
Thank you, Simon and Aliza. Everything you do is magical, and today was no exception. It's now the moment we've been waiting for. As the envelope is being held forth and the winner of the major award is announced, a drum roll. Ta-da, ta-da, ta-da. I invite Shirley Ann Haber, founding president of the Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation, to present the inaugural award of excellence to Jacques Gauthier. Shirley Ann will explain the award, its significance, and why it is being presented today to Jacques. And I must add that it is with significant appreciation from all of our listeners today and the 3,700 people who are regular supporters of CAEF that we welcome Shirley Ann now.
Dear Jacques, today we honor you as we celebrate the centennial of San Remo. After hearing so many comments this afternoon, there's no question that you are held in high esteem, such high esteem, by so many who greatly respect and admire you. Although you are not Jewish, you have shown great love and support for the Jewish people and Israel, the sovereign state of the Jewish people, and especially for the old city of Jerusalem, upon which much of your PhD thesis research is based. You had a sixth sense that our tiny little organization a few years ago would one day grow and make a difference. And of course, that is what happened. I was so impressed with your knowledge and ability that we had you speak for the Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation on several occasions. In 2017, in 2009, in 2018, you spoke, and your recent topic was Forget Politics, Who Has the Legal Rights to Jerusalem? At that time, our group went under the name of the Speakers Action Group. However, today we use our legal name to draw attention to the imperative of combating anti-Semitism and supporting Zionism. Thus, we are now the Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation, or CAEF, which is a little easier to say. When I see you in this photo in San Remo, Italy, in 2017, you are speaking behind a microphone, as you have done at so many lectures, in your passionate, gentle oratory style, committed to telling the story of our history and defending truth and fighting against injustice. I am struck also by this photo of you standing on the very steps in San Remo, Italy, where the Supreme Allied Powers after World War I stood, stating their famous resolution legalizing the message of Balfour, which is now embedded in the archives of the United Nations. You should feel extremely proud of what you have accomplished over the years. You have spoken to thousands upon thousands, to lawyers, leaders, members of parliament of different countries worldwide. And in the near future, you will be part of a program that Rabbi Kropotkin mentioned, speaking to students and teachers, Jewish and non-Jewish, and you will address rabbis across North America, a huge achievement, a plan that makes us all proud and happy, as your message will hopefully move world governments, world leaders that negotiate on behalf of Israel. And now, this gives me a very special, wonderful opportunity to present to you, on behalf of CAEF and all community supporters and all our attendees, at presenting you the inaugural CAEF Advocate Award of Excellence for your untiring work in promoting the legal rights of the Jewish people to the land of Israel. The original art is by Toronto artist Leah Krust. It depicts the original map of Israel as provided for at San Remo, surrounded by the flags of the four supreme allied powers that signed the declaration, Britain, Italy, France, and Japan, and the flag of the US, which had observer status. And near the top is the Israeli flag, where it should be. The Hebrew letters surrounding the six-pointed Star of David make up the words to the famous song, Yerushalayim Shel Zahav, Jerusalem of Gold. And the center states, Outstanding Advocate Award presented to Dr. Jacques Gauthier for excellence in scholarship and dedication in defending the legal rights of the Jewish people to the land of Israel. Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation, November 25th, 2020. We hope you will display this proudly in your home. We are so very proud to count you as a friend of Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation and all those who celebrate today. And we wish you many, many years of good health with your loving family, your wife, Rani, and your four beautiful daughters, Alicia, Shaloma, Adriella, and Davina. God bless you, Jacques Gauthier. And now we look forward to hearing from you.
Thank you, Shirley Ann. I am deeply moved. It's not often that I have some difficulty speaking. I always want the microphone because I have so much on my heart that I want to share, but this occasion is incredible. Thank you, Consul General Baram, for your very kind words. And thank you to my friends, Lewis, Michael Diamond, Yifa, Rabbi Kropotkin, my new friend. Thank you for what you're doing to open new doors. And this is a moment when I want to say thank you. I want to say thank you to all of you. Andrea, you've worked so hard. Many, many thanks. Shirley Ann, we've been friends for, it seems, quite a few decades. So this is a sweet moment. It has such a nice taste. And somehow I can't forget my mother tongue. And thank you seems inadequate. Merci, un grand merci, un énorme merci. Doesn't it sound better in French? And I want to say this. It's a moment when I want to focus. You can't do this without me having an opportunity to say a few more words about the San Remo conference, and I will. No presentation, no PowerPoints, but I want to again underline why it is such a defining moment in history. Before I do that, there are certain members of my family, people who have been part of this journey, of this quest for justice, that I want to bring to the forefront. I want to, for those of you who don't know my partner, my friend, my wife for over four decades, Rani. She has been a source of encouragement. She has been not only someone who has supported my work, but she was there when the discouragement set in, because you don't do something like this. It takes so long to complete, 20 years to complete the thesis. And I'm reminded of the days we used to drive to Florida with our four daughters, and they were young, and it was a long drive, and we'd be about 10 minutes away from the driveway in Toronto, and one of them would say, "Are we there yet, Daddy?" And it was a long drive, and we tried to make it interesting along the way. Well, when I was writing the thesis, it took a long, long time. You can't imagine the number of times I heard voices in my house saying, are we there yet, Daddy? It took so long because the facts are so numerous and it takes a while to put that puzzle together. So with my wife, I want to introduce my daughter, Shaloma, who did her PhD also at the same institute, the Graduate Institute of International Studies, and was there in Geneva to not only carry my bag, but to help me with research. And she devoted hundreds and hundreds of hours to undergird me and to help me and to guide me as a scholar. She's played such a crucial role in my life. Adriella, one of our twins, is a right hand. She works with me, she works for me, I work for her. Some days we get it mixed up, but such a central part of my life, and she's full of wisdom and technology and expertise in technology and how much of a difference she's made. Davina, I don't know if we can squeeze you here, go ahead, is another very key member of the family. And if you want to know the secret to being able to complete the work that I completed in 2006, here's the secret. They've loved me, they've encouraged me, they've done a lot of background work. And I have my firstborn, Alicia, the oldest, is in Hong Kong, so she can't be with us here in this moment, but she's a musician, she's a composer. And last night I received a composition from her. She composed something beautiful to encourage me and to acknowledge that this was indeed a special moment for our family. So I think it would be appropriate for Rani to say a few words before I continue.
Well, I would say that it's been a real honor for me to accompany Jacques on this journey. And I would say that for my daughters as well. It's been meaningful. It's been arduous and treacherous at times, a bit like Frodo in Lord of the Rings. And there were times when Jacques was practicing law full time while he was writing this, and he had the little girls, and he would say to me, I can't do this anymore. I'm going to die. I can't do this. And I would say to him, no, Jacques, you can't die until you've written this thesis, and then we'll see about it later. But until then, you're going to just focus and do this because it's a calling. It's a calling, and you cannot run away from a calling. And so, as you can see, he survived, is doing very well. And we have been so blessed by our trips to different parts of the world. We've met wonderful people, have forged amazing friendships, and have received a lot of love in return. And so I just want to thank all of you today for doing this.
Thank you. Again, without my family, no doubt, this would not have been possible. I have to acknowledge that without inspiration, without the animation that I received from above, from God, I would not have continued my work. I received a card from a very dear, dear couple that has been following my work for years. And I'll mention their names, Joe and Renana. And the card said, Dear Dr. Gauthier, thank you for our friendship and your holy work and for your family who keep you warm and strong. Right on. I must tell you, when I started my research, I didn't understand the extent to which this was holy work. I was so moved by the song a few moments ago. The dimensions of what I've pursued are beyond my ability to explain. What I can tell you is that the reason it's having an impact is it's because it's the truth. I'm bringing truth to light, truth that is way beyond Jacques Gauthier. It's the truth that has had the impact. The truth is out.
the truth for different reasons was hidden, and the machinations of the nations effectively kept it hidden. So many fabrications of false narratives prevailed. But how joyful I am with you today to be part of this celebration of the San Remo Conference and what you're doing in my regard to my work, because it means that more light is being shed on these truths. I want to underline the fact that along the way, I was inspired. I was touched by many, just to mention a few, Herzl. I had to become intimate with his work, with his life. And I couldn't believe the combination of brilliance and political activism. He was a man of vision with determination in respect to a solution to the Jewish problem, a Jewish state. I was inspired by that man. And then Chaim Weizmann, a true modern architect of the reconstituted state of Israel. How impressed, how inspired I was as I studied his writings for years. He's like he was my friend. Same with Balfour, who impressed me because he was a Christian who decided that it was time to repair the harm done to the Jewish people for so long. And then there was people like Ord Wingate. Some of you may not know him, but a Christian British soldier who helped to train soldiers in the mid-1930s, and he made a difference, but he was so dedicated and determined to make a difference. How inspiring his life was. Now, a few years ago, I want to thank you, Charles, for your words. Your work is incredibly significant, and I want to thank you for everything that you do, but I don't know if the audience is aware that the new chair of ISGAP is Nathan Sharansky. In 2009, I met Nathan Sharansky, and he gave me a copy of a book called, his new book at the time, called Defending Identity. And in the book, he wrote to Jacques Gauthier with deep appreciation for your work in defending our identity. What I've come to realize is that the identity of the Jewish people of Israel is definitely linked to the legal foundations that I present, meaning that Jews, Israelis, are not thieves. They're not usurpers. They're not wrongdoers in regard to the land of Israel. They are there as of right. And it's this crucial truth which should undergird their identity and continue to do so. And this motivates me so much. The San Remo Conference was the moment when the Balfour Declaration was crowned. The decisions made there reflected in different instruments are now part of international law. The Jews have the right to be anywhere and everywhere in the land of Israel and the Holy Land and everything that's on the west side of the Jordan River. So today, I want to thank you and at the same time, exhort you to do what you can, because so many have already stepped in. Even within the government of Israel, there's been a complete transformation. They've organized two conferences to present my arguments and findings. There is some momentum, yet in the midst of such increasing anti-Semitism, anti-Zionism. So from the bottom of my heart, I thank you. I will never forget this moment, my friends. I will be motivated further. I will be thankful, but I don't see this as it's a milestone perhaps, but so much more needs to be done. We're still in a way scraping the surface, and I look forward, Rabbi Kropotkin, to the opportunity of sharing the truths that we've referred to today with many rabbis and students in high schools and beyond. From the bottom of my heart, thank you to all of you for doing this.
Shirley Ann, thank you also for your contribution and the beautiful gift you've bestowed upon Jacques. Congratulations, Jacques, mazel tov. And we should let the party continue with more music. So in that regard, I'm happy to introduce Cantor Tibor Kavori of the Beth Tikva Synagogue in Toronto. And in keeping with our theme of commemorating San Remo and recognizing our eternal capital of Jerusalem, Cantor Kavori will sing Yerushalayim Shel Zahav, Jerusalem of Gold. Let's all enjoy.
Avin harim tzalul kayayin ve'reachod amin. Nisa beruach arbaim im kol pa'amonim. Luftar demat ilan va'ev Shuya b'chalomah Ha'ir asher badad yoshevet Uvelimah chomah Yerushalayim shel zahav V'shel nechoshet v'shel or Halol Yerushalayim shel zahav v'shel nechoshet v'shel or halo lechol shirayich hamikinot chazar l'dorot hamayim lashut Shofar kore be'arabayit ma'in ha'atika Uvam me'arot asher v'asel alfei shmashot zorecho Ashov ered el yam ha'melach ederech yericho Yerushalayim shel zahav v'shel nechoshet v'shel or halo lechol shirayich hamikinot Yerushalayim shel zahav v'shel nechoshet v'shel
beautiful Kanta Kavori. Thank you for their heart-rending rendition of a beautiful favorite loved song. Again, congratulations, Jacques. Many thanks for Shirley Ann's presentations and establishing, say, CAEF, and to hold high the banner of Zionism and to fight against hatred against all minorities, especially Jew hatred. We are on your team. We look forward to continuing the battle with you. Anita Bromberg, the president of CAEF, the board of directors, volunteers, and executive director, Adira Spindle. Jacques, may you go from strength to strength. And now, for all of our home audience and listeners, we're very special honoree. We have a unique gift, the voices of several friends and colleagues of Jacques who have sent their personal greetings, well wishes, mazel tovs, thanks yous, and blessings for the valuable service and work that you do, Jacques. They have performed on behalf of Amris Yisrael all kind of great wishes to you. I read the names in order of the speakers on this recorded video and know that many more had wished to be included, but time did not permit. You'll see and hear from Tom Sandell, president of the European Coalition for Israel, who's from Finland and who I met for the first time in San Remo in 2017. Mark Boyman, producer and actor. Donna Holbrook, president of the International Christian Embassy in Jerusalem. Julia Koschitsky, a leading activist and former president of the Jerusalem Foundation. Leo Adler, a lawyer, activist and member of the Board of Canadians for the Rule of Law. Judy Friedman Kaddish, co-executive director of Americans for a Safe Israel. Daniel Karen, executive director of Hasbara Fellowship Canada, and Goldie Steiner, co-chair of our lead support organization, Canadians for Israel Legal Rights. Video presentation will now begin. Thank you.
Congratulations, dear Jacques, to a very well-deserved award. I still remember when we met the first time in 2009 in Washington, and you brought your thesis, and life hasn't quite been the same ever since. And as you recall, we've been together to Tokyo, Brussels, Rome, London, New York, you name it, to present your very profound and important conclusions in those theses. And I so much wish I could have been there in Toronto today together with you and Rani to celebrate this memorable event, but I hope to see you soon again when the travel restrictions are lifted so that we can celebrate properly in person. Once more, mazel tov, congratulations, well done, Jacques.
Good evening. Jacques is a gift, a cadeau in French, to so many of us here, and I've come to see far beyond. Jacques gifted us with a copy of his extraordinarily researched and, may I say, dauntingly thick PhD thesis. In amazing detail and logical rigor, this thesis provides a major reset of reality over perception about Jerusalem's legal status internationally, as well as the region around it. Promoting and propagating indisputable facts, going against the grain, is something Jacques is gradually and passionately succeeding at. Amazing. On a personal note, in addition to the blessing of Rani and their magnificent daughters living near us at the cottage, Jacques also happens to live near us in the city. And we regularly promenade ourselves through the neighborhood as the boulevardier that we could reasonably assert that we are. Yes, we solve the world's problems on these walks as well. And we're, may I say, really good at it too. Self-assessed. The Middle East, no problem. Ever heard of the Abraham Accords? Need I say more? And we're so glad that we have met the extraordinary and by now good friend Jacques Gauthier, who combines remarkably wide-ranging interests and opinions so perfectly with his passionate focus, especially on the subject, of course, of Jerusalem and the Jewish people. Congratulations to our Cadeau Magnifique. This award, Jacques, is so very much deserved. Your friend, Mark.
Shalom, I'm Donna Holbrook, Executive Director of the International Christian Embassy, Jerusalem in Canada. It gives us great pleasure at ICJ to offer our collective congratulations to our good friend and longtime associate, Dr. Jacques Gauthier, who was the recipient of the Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation's inaugural Advocate Award of Excellence. This award is to honor his remarkable work on behalf of the State of Israel and the Jewish people. Having been a longtime sponsor of this fine foundation, we are delighted and proud to join in celebration of the work of Dr. Gauthier on this significant selection. Jacques and his family have been longtime friends and supporters of ICJ Canada, where he has also served on our board of directors. We look forward with enthusiasm in joining you on the celebration of the 100th anniversary of San Remo to honor Dr. Gauthier.
Jack, you'll be happy to hear that Henry and I will be arriving in Jerusalem on the very same time that hundreds of your friends, family, admirers will be offering their words of congratulations to you on this great honor. We know that Jerusalem holds a special place in your heart. You have been that quiet, quintessential advocate, the voice for human rights and the sovereignty of Jerusalem for so many decades. And your work on the thesis of this subject is a work of love, not just for the Jewish nation, but for all of humanity. So we wish you good health, long life, determination and wisdom to carry out your noble deeds on behalf of humankind. And hopefully when the pandemic is over, you and Rani can come to Israel once again and we can see each other in our home as we did once before hosting you. Our best wishes to you and congratulations on this so well-deserved honor.
Mon cher Jacques, alors ça c'est la deuxième fois que je vous envoyais mes blessings. Vous êtes une très chère amie, une très chère copain, et à cause de vous, nous avons une bonne cause. Alors, all the very best to you. You're a terrific friend to me and to all of us. All the best.
Hi, I'm Judy Friedman Kadish, co-executive director of Americans for a Safe Israel, better known as AFSI. I'm here today to say congratulations and thank you to Dr. Jacques Gauthier for his seminal work on Israel's sovereignty rights under international law stemming from the San Remo Agreement. I also want to thank him very, very much for participating in a Zoom meeting with us several months ago that is still available on our website at afsi.org. And Dr. Gauthier, you deserve every award and every thank you that that you get. And I just wish you continued good luck and success in bringing this to the attention of the entire world. Thank you, thank you. Shalom.
Hi, this is Daniel Corin, Director of Hasbara Fellowships Canada, and I would like to thank Andrea Spindel and CAEF for all the incredible and vital work they do on behalf of our community and for having us here on the 100th anniversary of San Remo. I would also like to bestow greetings from everyone at Hasbara, from all our student fellows on this momentous occasion, honoring Jacques Gauthier. As an organization that values education as a means to combat anti-Semitism and anti-Israel propaganda, we believe it's very important to know about people like Gauthier. He is a pivotal figure in understanding the legal rights of the Jewish people when it comes to the land of Israel, and this is something so vital for our students to know. Thanks again, Andrea.
Dear Dr. Gauthier, I salute you as one of Israel's best and most loyal friends, and also my personal cherished friend for over a decade. You and your lovely wife, Rami, in the spirit of Shershela Fam, deserve the distinction to be counted among the righteous, among the righteous. And now it gives me pleasure, together with Irving, to present you with our token of appreciation for your tireless work to spread knowledge about Israel's legal rights all over the world. A word of merit to Dr. Jacques Gauthier for your lifelong dedication in defense of Israel's legal rights. Presented by Canadians for Israel's Legal Rights, November 25, 2020, Goldie Steiner and Irving Weisdorf.
That was wonderful. And Jacques, you know, that's only an appetizer of the people who really care for you. And thank you to everybody who contributed. So we're now bringing our musical performance to you from Israel. It's a closing act for our celebration. And it's been prepared specially for today's event to honor Jacques and celebrate his life and work. I'm thrilled to introduce Yonina. The singing duo is comprised of Yoni and Nina Tokyayer, who combined their names to create Yonina. Here is a short background note on Yonina. The couple started posting videos in 2016, and the cover song One Day reached over 40 million views from around the globe. In September 2017, they released their debut album, Emet Pshuta, or Simple Truth, which had several original hit songs. For the past 3 years, Yonina has been performing throughout Israel, the US, and Europe in both large-scale concerts and private events. They are currently working on a second album and producing music videos. They have been married for 4 years and have two small children, Ashira and Achiyah Yehuda. The family lives in the rural city of Padres Chana in northern Israel. I hope everyone enjoys these two songs, Shevet Achim V'Yachod, which means tribe of my brothers and sisters, with the chorus, Here is my home, here is my heart. This will be followed by a special song on our theme entitled Jerusalem Mashup. Yonin recording is about to begin. Thank you.
Hi.
Hi, we're Yonina.
Thank you to the Canadian Anti-Semitism Education Foundation and all the sponsors of this event for including us in this event. It recalls the importance of the San Remo Agreements and honors the work of Dr. Gauthier, who does really important work to prove our connection as a Jewish people to the land of Israel. So as an Israeli musical duo, we're very happy to be here.
We'll be singing our Jerusalem mashup, and hope you enjoy.
Shivim shana b'mechonit Ani nosea u'mabit Al maya u'maniya Ve'ech nafshi odomiya
במצדה של הזריחות ירושלים בסליחות בחוף כנרת ואכזיב מהמסיבות של תל אביב אבי חלם והתפלל לחיות בארץ ישראל היום ילדי אותי שואל סיפור של ישראל כאן זה בית כאן זה לב ואותך אני לא עוזב אבותינו שורשים ואנחנו הפרחים המנגינות של הדרכים והחיות כאן זה בית כאן זה
Jerusalem, they fight for God.
Jerusalem. If I forget you, ooh, Jerusalem. If I forget you,
Zion, I come down from your tongue.
Jerusalem, if I forget you,
turn our hand, forget what it's supposed to do.
Jerusalem, if I forget you,
Zion, I come down from your tongue.
Jerusalem, if I forget you,
turn our hand, forget what it's supposed to do.
Yeah, that was fun. Toda rabba, Yoni and Nina. I hope you're watching. I know it's evening if you are. And at the moment now, we're bringing our virtual celebration to a conclusion with joy in our hearts, hope in our minds, and love for Jacques Gauthier and the work he does, as well as shared commitment to continue acting for the end of Jew hatred and to protect our democracy and the sovereignty of Israel. Thanks again to all our many community support organizations, our speakers, singers, greeters, and guests. Good day, good evening, shalom, stay safe and be well, and share the news. Jews were granted the legal right to Israel in the Mandate for Palestine at San Remo in 1920. We hope you will register to join CAEF on December 8th for a virtual Hanukkah Zoom-a-thon. Again, it's been my honor and my pleasure to share this afternoon, this evening, with all the people who participated in this fantastic memory. I'm very proud to be part of it.
Thank you, Louis. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Yifa.
God bless, Jacques.
Thank you, Charles, Michael, everyone. Thank you.